Hi everyone, my name is Mohammed, and in this step-by-step tutorial, I'll show you how you can set many things as default, especially font size, page size, and margins. Next, we will dive a little deeper into the shortcut keys, and we'll also unleash the power of Clipboard. In the end, I have two surprise tips for you, so make sure that you watch complete video. If you want to go to specific chapter, I have also included timestamps in the description. But before starting, make sure that you are running the latest version of Microsoft Office so you can follow along. So without wasting time, let's jump to the PC. Tip number one is set as default. You can set many things as default, but most of the time our university, school or college has some specific guidelines on font size, paper size and margins. And you already know that whenever you open your new document, the default font is Calibri and the default font size is 11. And in case of paper size, the default size is letter and the default margins are 1 inch for top, bottom, left and right. So whenever you open your document, you change the font size, paper size and margins. To avoid this, the Word has an option which is known as set as default. So to change the font and the font size to default, I'll go to home, and in the home I'll choose font, and from the font I'll click on this little arrow for more options. So as you can see that I have Calibri font and the font size is 11. To change the font, say for example I'll choose Times New Roman as a default font and 12 size, and now I'll click set as default. And in this I have two options. The first one is this document only, and the second one is all documents based on the normal template. I'll choose second option and then I'll choose OK. And for the paper size, I'll go to layout, and in the layout I have page setup, and in the page setup I'll again click this arrow, and in this I have the margins option, and for the left margin I'll choose 1.25 inches and for the paper I'll choose A4, and then I'll select set as default. This change will affect all new documents based on the normal template. I'll press yes. So whenever I'll again open my document, I have the default font which will be Times New Roman, font size will be 11, paper size will be A4, and the left margin will be 1.25 inches. The tip number two is the use of shortcut keys, and I am pretty sure that you people are already using many shortcut keys, but I have compiled a list of 7 keys that will be very helpful for you if you are a student. So the first one is justify the text. So as you can see that my text is not correctly aligned according to the paper size. I'll just click anywhere in the paragraph and just press Ctrl plus J. So you can see that now my paragraph is correctly aligned according to the screen or the paper size. And the next one we have is line spacing. The paragraph has single line space, but I want to convert it to double line space. So I'll again click anywhere in the paragraph and just press Ctrl and 2. So you can see that now my paragraph is converted from single line space to double line space. The third one we have is navigation pane. Say for example, if I want to search a specific word in my document, so I'll just press Ctrl and F, and I want to search the word population in my document. So you can see that the word population appears 3 times in my documents, and if I want to navigate to specific portion, I'll just press here. So you can see that the word automatically navigates me to the specific portion of my document. And the next one we have is save as. If I want to save this document to another name or to another location, I'll just press F12. Save as window will appear, so you can name your document or save your document to your computer. The fifth shortcut key for select all we have is Control plus A. If I want to change the font of my entire document, I'll just press Control and A. So from the font, I want to select the Century Gothic. Now my entire document is converted from Time New Roman to Century Gothic. So, and the next one we have is move cursor to the beginning of the document. My cursor is at this portion and I want to move my cursor to the beginning of the document. I'll just press Control and Home. Now my cursor is at the beginning of the document. And last but not the least, we have moves cursor to the end of the document, and the shortcut key for this is Control plus End. For this, I'll just press Control and End, and now my cursor is at the end of my document. The tip number 3 is the power of Clipboard. So you people are already familiar with the command Control C for copy and Control V for paste. So first of all, I'll copy Pakistan and then its capital Islamabad, and then I'll copy India and its capital New Delhi. So now if I go down here and I want to paste all these items below, so I'll just press Control V. So you can see that it only pasted the last item which I copied, which was New Delhi. So I want to copy all these items. To do this, just go to Home, and under the Clipboard group, press on this little arrow. So you can see that in Clipboard, I have all the items which I copied in my entire document. So at down here, first of all, I want to mention India and then its capital New Delhi, and then I want to mention Pakistan and then its capital Islamabad. Tip number 4 is rewrite suggestions. So the Microsoft Word wants to improve the way you write. So I have already written a text which is, I'm not a Microsoft Word expert, but every day I learn something new. Say for example, I want to change, learn something new. So I'll select this, right click, and then I'll click on rewrite suggestion. So a pane will appear which is showing me 3 suggestions. The first one is learn new things, find out something new, and discover something new. So this looks good. I'll choose discover something new. So now my sentence is, I'm not a Microsoft Word expert. The word expert, I don't like the word expert. So I'll again select this and then right click, rewrite suggestions. So I have 2 suggestions, which is specialist or specialist. So I'll choose specialist. So now my sentence is look polished, which is, I'm not a Microsoft Word specialist, but every day I discover something new. So one thing you have to keep in mind, that the word will not completely rewrite your sentence or your paragraph. Say for example, I choose this, right click, and then I'll again click on rewrite suggestions. So no suggestions, try selecting another short phrase. So tip number 5 is remove background. Did you know the Word has an option in which you can easily remove a background from your picture? But don't expect the Word to remove complex background from your picture, because you are not working on Adobe Photoshop. And one more thing, don't just copy images from the Google Images and use them in your assignments or your projects. There are hundreds of sites over the internet from where you can download your image and use them anywhere you want. My favorite are unsplash.com, pexel.com, and pixabay.com. So for this tutorial, I'll use unsplash.com. So as you can see, that the internet's source of freely usable images, and in the search I'll search rice, enter, and I'll choose a simple picture. Yes, this looks simple, so I'll click on it and I'll choose my download size and I'll choose medium. So say thanks, give a shout out to Pixola Photography on social, or copy the text below to attribute. So now I'm going to insert the image in my document and go to insert pictures in this device, and just like this, and so insert. So this was the picture, and I'll give the credit. To remove the background of the picture, I'll just select picture, and then I'll choose this option, picture format. And in the picture format, the word gave me an option, which is remove background. I'll select this. So now you notice that the word itself removes the background of the picture, which is showing me in purple color. So I'll select keep changes. So one thing you notice that the hand of the woman is not properly showing in the picture. So I'll again go to remove background, and I'll choose the option mark areas to keep. And then I'll roughly draw on the hand like this. Now I'll again select keep changes. Now you can see that how the word perfectly removes the background of my picture. Okay, that brings us to the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my tutorial. Please like the video. If you have any question, leave a comment, and subscribe to my channel if you want more tutorials like this.